Hello! Today we will cover the levels of structural organization of the human body. These levels will help us understand how our body works. Now, you might be wondering, why is the structure so important? Well, simply because the structure of an organ dictates its function. In other words, by understanding the structure of an organ, you could actually predict its function. For example, the lungs have elastic fibers that allows them to expand while breathing. Therefore, if we find elastic fibers in another organ we know nothing about, we would recognize that this unknown organ is capable of expanding. This is mainly why we say that anatomy and physiology work together. The first level is the chemical level. It is the basic level. It is made up of the atoms and the molecules. As we know, atoms are the smallest unit of matter. In this page, we are seeing the essential atoms for life highlighted in blue. They are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, calcium, and sulfur. When two or more atoms join together, they make a molecule, such as the glucose molecule or the DNA molecule. Now, the second level is the cellular level. Molecules combine to form cells. We have several kinds of cells in our body. For example, the ones represented here are the muscle cells. We also have the nerve cells, the epithelial cells, etc. By definition, the cell is the basic structural and functional unit of an organism. The third level is the tissue level. Tissues of the body are formed by a group of cells and the material that surrounds them. In these pictures, we are seeing three similar models of smooth muscle tissues. In our body, we have four types of tissues: epithelial tissues, muscular tissues, nervous tissues, and connective tissues. The next level of structural organization is the organ level. Our organs, such as the heart, the lungs, the kidneys, etc., are formed by two or more different types of tissues. For example, the blood vessel is an organ because it is formed by three types of tissues: the smooth muscle tissue in the middle, the epithelial tissue lining the interior of the blood vessel, and the connective tissue as the outermost layer. Now, it is important to note that organs have specific function and recognizable shapes. By knowing that, we will be able to understand the next level, the system level. Because a system consists of related organs with a common function, such as the cardiovascular system, that consists of the heart, blood vessels, and blood. This system has three main functions: transport of nutrients, oxygen, and hormones to cells throughout the body, and removal of metabolic wastes. You should know that we have 11 systems in our body. In future videos, I will try to cover each one of them. The last level is the organismal level. All of the parts of the body functioning together form the organism. Now, finally, this is a clear summary of all the levels of structural organization of the human body. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you have any question, don't hesitate to ask it in the comments. Bye!